Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube videos. In this video, I'm going to solve another popular prime in probability theory called the best price primes. So here is the prime. So that's kind of a game, and the rules of the game are the following. You assume that you have n distinct prices that are presented one by one to a player. So distinct prices here means that you can rank them from the best one to the worst one, and we also assume that the player is able to do this ranking, assuming that she got to see all the prices. However, instead of seeing all the price at once, she can only see them sequentially and one by one, and we assume that all the possible n factorial permutation of those n prices are equally likely. Now, the game is as follows. The player at each time she sees a price, the player has the option to stop playing and keep this price and live with that price, or reject the price and continue playing to hopefully find a better price. So, of course, the goal of the game, that's the title of the prime, it's to find the best price, and the goal is to compute the probability of finding the best price. So, a natural strategy that the player can follow is to do the following. So, you fix an integer n, which is strictly less than n, than the number of prices, and the player can reject the first m prices, and then after she sees the first m prices and know about their values, she can continue playing and just accept the first price after those first m that is better than the first m prices she saw. Okay, and I'm adding in the slide, provided there is one such price, meaning that if the best price was in the first m prices that she already rejected, then eventually she's not going to accept any of the following prices, except of course the last one, so that she lives with something. So in this case, she would miss the best price, because the best price is not in the in the first m. So to give you an example, a more concrete example, let's assume that this is your birthday, and you got from your friends those eight birthday presents in the picture. So now, from the boxes, you have no way to tell which present is your favorite present. And life is cruel, you are not allowed to open all your presents and keep all of them. You can only keep one of them. And life is even more cruel than just looking at all of them and only keep your favorite one. You can only do the following. You can only choose one present, open your present, and based on what the present is, decide to keep it or continue opening present, and you can only keep the last present you opened. So, for instance, in this case, n equals 8, and let's assume, for instance, that you take m equals 3, and following the strategy described, that would mean that you are going to take 3 presents at random, you are going to open them, you decide, no matter what you find, you are going to decide to reject those 3 presents, you decide to not take those 3 presents, then you open a 4th one. If the 4th one is better than the first 3, then you live with it. If it's not as good as the first 3, then you open a 5th one, and so on. So now, of course, the goal of the prime is to compute the probability of finding the best price. So first step, we are going to use conditional probabilities to compute the probability of finding the best price. That's going to be a function that depends on n and m. And then after, it turns out that we can compute explicitly the maximal probability of selecting the best price and prove that when n goes to infinity, asymptotically, the probability of finding the best price is 1 over e, which is a pretty good probability, which is larger, in fact, than 1/3. So of course, by maximal probability here, what we mean is that we have a probability that is a function of n and m. We take the limit when n goes to infinity, and we are going to be able to find a specific value of m that's going to be some kind of optimal value to maximize this probability. And for this best possible value of m, you can prove that in the limit, your probability of finding the best price is as high as 1 over e. So the first step to solve the problem is to compute the probability of finding the best price as a function of n and m with no specific assumption about n and m. Then only in the second step, we are going to find the value of m that maximizes this probability. So of course, the goal is to find the probability of the event finding the best price. So I'm going to give a name to that event. I'm going to call b. B means I'm just going to write best price. So that's the event that you find the best price. And so this video is in the topic of conditional probability. So the idea to compute this probability is going to be to condition on some other, let's say maybe a partition of events or a random variable. So in this case, if you only think of the problem, it's clear that there is an obvious quantity that if you knew this quantity, you would be able always to find the best price. That's exactly the position of the best price. At which step the best price is going to appear, I'm going to call that X, and it turns out that if you know X, then you could find the best price, and then you can find the probability of finding the best price given all the possible values of X under the strategy like rejecting the first M and taking the best one, the first one that is better than the first M in a later time. So I'm going to condition eventually on this random variable. So I'm going to call X the position of the best price, okay? And so doing this, you see that intuitively, if X is less than M, meaning that the best price is in the first M, then the conditional probability of B given X equals something less than M is going to be zero, because you are going to miss it because you reject the first M. Similarly, if X is very large, is close to N, then it's likely that also you are going to miss it because you reject a first block of prices, but then after you are kind of likely to find something better than those first M before you reach N. So it seems that the probability of B given X equals, let's say, little x, is going to be zero if little x is less or equal to m, and it's going to be very high if the position of the best price is m plus 1, but then it's going to slowly decrease as you keep looking at prices. So in this case, so let's look at p of b. So of course, using the conditioning, that means that we are going to write that P of B is the same as the expected value of P of B given X. So again, be careful, X is not an event, it's a random variable. And so P of B given X is a random variable, and it turns out that the expected value of this random variable is the same as the probability of B. If you use the fact that X is a discrete random variable with range 1, 2, 3 up to n, that's all the possible positions of the best price, then you can rewrite this expected value in this form. So that's going to be the sum for all x equals 1 to n of the probability that you find the best price given that x equals little x times the probability that x equals little x. So there are two things you can do here to simplify this sum, two obvious things. So because we assume that all n factorial possible permutations of the prices are equally likely, that means that the best price is at position 1 with 0.1 over n. I mean, the position of the best price is basically going to be the uniform random variable on the set 1, 2, 3 up to n, okay? So each position is the best price is equally likely to be in each of the n positions. So that means that this probability is just 1 over n. And like we said before, it's clear that if I'm computing here this probability under the strategy, again, rejecting the first m prices and taking the best, the first one better than the first m that you find after. So if the best price is in the first m, obviously you are going to miss it because you are going to reject it and you are not going to find anything better after. So that means that this sum becomes just 1 over n. 1 over n is exactly this probability here, and that is the same for all x, and then you multiply by the sum for x equals m plus 1 up to n. So m plus 1, because we said that for all x larger or equal to m, this conditional probability is going to be 0. So you have this simpler sum, so of course you still have the probability of B given that X equals X. And the difficult part in some way, it's to compute this conditional probability. So let's draw a picture to understand this. So let's assume that these are all your prices. So you see price number 1, then 2, and so on, then up to price number M, that's the one that you reject. And then now we are in the case where your best price is at position x, which is after that. So you have n here. Let's assume the best price is at this position. So now you see that given that the best price is at this position, the probability that you are going to find it is the probability that none of the prices between m plus 1 and x minus 1 are better than the first m, okay? So this probability here, I'm going to say that it's equal to this conditional probability, it's the probability that eventually the best price among the first x minus 1 prices, so I can write x minus 1 here, if the best of those x minus 1 prices is among the first m, then you get it. You get the best price. Why? Because if the best of the first x minus 1 is in the first m, that means that you are going to reject prices m plus 1, m plus 2 up to x minus 1, and then you are going to find x. At the opposite, if one of those prices here is better than any of the first n, then you are going to take that one and you are going to miss x. So this conditional probability is exactly the probability that the best among the first x minus 1 prices, okay, is in the first m. Okay, and so now using again the fact that all the n factorial possible permutations are equally likely, you can deduce from that, okay, that so the probability that the best price among those ones, so maybe let me draw this in red. So you look at all those prices, so you have x minus 1 prices, and you want that the best one among all those ones is in the first m. So this probability is exactly just some kind of basic proportion because of, you know, everything is equally likely or uniformly distributed. So that's going to be exactly, this probability is going to be exactly m divided by x minus 1, okay? So eventually you get that this is m divided by x minus 1, so you get that this sum simplifies to 1 over n times the sum for x equals m plus 1 to n of, and so we said this should be m divided by x minus 1. Okay, and then I'm just going to write one more step to slightly simplify this, like using some basic algebra. And so you understood this part, then you can simplify this a little bit. You see that the sum is over x, so I can put the m outside the sum. So you start with some m over n, and then multiply by the sum for x. So when x is equal to m plus 1, this x minus 1 is equal to m. So I'm just going to start the sum at x equals m. And of course, you have to stop at n minus 1 instead. And then that's the sum of just the 1 over x. So I can expand that also and say that it's m divided by n times. So you have 1 over m plus 1 over m plus 1 and so on. And you stop at 1 over n minus 1. So you see that indeed, you can think of this sum as something which is of the form 1 plus 1 half plus 1 third and so on, and you go up to 1 over n minus 1. So the first part of the sum is cut, that corresponds to those conditional probabilities that are equal to 0 if the best price is in the first n. And you see that if the best price is at position m plus 1, then you cannot miss it. You are going to find it for sure. And indeed, if you forget this 1 over n that comes from those probabilities, you get this m over n that is equal to 1. Then after, at the opposite, if the best price is close to the end, your probability of finding it, again, forgetting about this 1 over n coming from that, is going to be of the form m over n. So we have indeed that this conditional probability, like we anticipated, is 0 when x is too small. Then after it becomes very high, but then it slowly decreases as you go over all the prices. Now let's go back to the slide. So you see that the goal eventually was to prove that this maximal probability was 1 over e in the limit when n goes to infinity. Now that we know the expression of the probability as a function of n and m, we can solve completely the problem. So back to the board, I rewrote the result we just proved. So by conditioning on x, we were able to prove that the probability of finding the best price following this strategy of rejecting the first m price is equal to that. So now what we are going to do is take the limit when n goes to infinity. Of course, we expect that n should also go to infinity, and we are going to take m of the form c times n. So the interpretation of c, c is going to be a number between 0 and 1, a real number between 0 and 1, and this number c corresponds to the fraction, the proportion of prices you need to reject at first, and that's going to be the optimal, eventually we want to find the optimal fraction of prices you want to reject so that you maximize your probability of finding the best price. So for that, I'm going to just say that so m is of the form c times n. C again is the proportion of prices we are going to reject. And then in this case, I'm going to write that in the limit when n goes to infinity, so eventually m is equal to cn, when you take the limit when n goes to infinity, you end up with a function that only depends on c, that's a function of c. So I'm going to write that phi of c. So c of c by definition is going to be the limit when n goes to infinity of this probability of finding the best price. And given also, I mean, under the condition that m is equal to cn. So if you look at this sum, so clearly that's going to give you the limit when n goes to infinity. of, so this M over N becomes C, and then you still have this sum going from this time Cn to let's say N minus 1, 1 over X. So now it turns out that this 1 over X, the sum of the 1 over X, is well approximated by the natural log. So, meaning that if we start from X equals 1 here, this expression would be about log N. So, because you can rewrite this sum as the sum from 1 to N minus 1 minus the sum from 1 to Cn minus 1, eventually, you can say that in the limit, this thing, I mean, that thing is equal to the limit when n goes to infinity of c times log of n, natural log of n minus natural log of cn. Now, basic properties of the log, log of n or log a minus log b is log a divided by b. Here it's going to give you a log n divided by cn, that's a log 1 over c. So eventually in the limit you get c times log 1 over c. So I don't really like the 1 over c, but that's easy to get rid of. You just say that log 1 over c is just minus log of c, and then eventually you end up with minus c log c. So that's the expression of the probability of finding the best price when the number of prices is very large, and under the strategy that you reject a fraction C of the prices. So for instance, if C is equal to 0.2 and you have 100 prices, that means you reject the first 20 prices. So we end up with that. I'm going to rewrite this result here. So what we just proved is that this is minus C log C. So this probability is minus C log C. Now we want to find the value of C that maximizes this function. So we just take the derivative. So if you look at the derivative of phi, you get so minus log C. Then you have minus C times the derivative of log, it's 1 over C, so minus C times 1 over C, that gives you a minus 1. So that's the derivative of phi, and of course we want to see when this expression is equal to 0 to find the maximum possible values of phi, where the maximum is reached. And so clearly, so the answer to that is going to be log C equals negative 1. So if and only if log C equals negative 1, which gives you C equals 1 over E. Okay, so if and only if C is equal to 1 over E. So now be careful, that doesn't tell you yet that the maximal probability is equal to 1 over E. That tells you that the best possible strategy, when the number of prices is large and your strategy is to reject the first M prices, this calculation just tells you that the best possible strategy is to reject a fraction 1 over E, so that's between 1/3 and 1/2. So a fraction 1 over E of the prices, and then you accept the first one you find after that that is better than the first M. That only tells you about which strategy you should follow. Now, to indeed compute the probability, you still need to compute phi of 1 over E, but it turns out that if you look at phi of 1 over E, so that's exactly this, so we are here, that's exactly the minus 1 over E times log 1 over E. Again, log 1 over E is minus log E, which is equal to 1, so that means that this expression is equal to 1 over E. So you see, that's interesting here. The proof here doesn't just tell you that the maximal probability is equal to 1 over e. That also tells you about for which value of c you are going to indeed get this optimal strategy. And interestingly, is that the value of c is equal to the maximal probability. So that means that c equals 1 over e is in fact a fixed point of this function phi that describes the probability of finding the best price.